So you know how people are like, you shouldn't compare yourself to others. Well, I think that's bullshit. Let me tell you why. What's up, everyone? My name is James Q. Quick, and I do weekly videos on web development related topics. And this video is the kickoff? The first video in a new series called Quick Rants, where I get to rant about something quickly, if that wasn't obvious from the text. But this is my way of kind of picking topics that I'm really passionate about and sharing that with you in mostly just kind of a talking head type video. So this topic today is about comparing yourself to others and why I think you absolutely should. Now, a lot of advice you get from people is never to compare yourself to others. And I think that comes from a good place. It comes from a place of kind of protecting yourself, of being respectful to yourself, and kind of understanding that people are in different stages of their career. They have different experiences. They have different paths. Everybody is different. But embracing that and using it as you compare yourself to me, I think is really important. So here's a couple of specific examples for me that I think are really relevant. And the key to this is you don't know what you're capable of until you see what other people are capable of. Now, here's a specific example for me. I have a goal this year in 2021, by the end of the year, to get to 100,000 subscribers on YouTube. I am currently at 80, currently at 75 or so, approaching 80. And I'm starting to feel really confident that I will meet that goal. But if I had not seen other people do this, people like the growth of the Coder channel, the Code Stacker channel, Florin Pop, Anya Kubo, if I had not seen these people grow so quickly, I would never have thought it was possible for me to have the goal that I have now and then actually achieve it. Even when I set the goal at the beginning of this year of 2021 of getting to 100,000 subscribers, I legitimately didn't think it was possible. But I knew it was possible because I had seen other people do it. Now, here's another example of something that I never would have thought I would have been able to do had I not seen other people do it. This was the 1 week challenge. So this was creating our 1 week product challenge. This was creating a product in 1 week. I mean, how quick of a turnaround is that? You have to make the product, you have to create a landing page, you have to figure out how to sell it, you have to try to market it, newsletter, all these different things. But Joe Privet started this out with his Vim for VS Code product. He shipped that in a week. He then kind of started this wave of people creating products in 1 week. And I saw how successful they were. Success is relative, right? Different amounts of sales and exposure and all those things. But I saw people being what I would consider really successful creating a product in a week. So I decided to do the same thing. Another couple of examples of that, by the way, Will Johnson created his How to Break into Tech Twitter ebook. Sam Juline created his Getting Started in Developer Relations ebook. And then I created my YouTube for Developers ebook to tell you all, if you're interested, how to get started with YouTube as a developer and why you might want to. What are the benefits? So this is actually available at youtubefordevelopers.com. But the point is, I never thought I would have been capable of creating a successful product in 2 weeks, or in a week, not even 2 weeks, in just 1 week. I also kind of look to maybe the next steps in my career a little bit longer term. And I think at some point I will probably create like a SaaS product, a paid SaaS product. I never would have thought that would have been possible if I hadn't seen so many other people doing that on Twitter and in Discord and on Slack. Seeing what other people are capable of really makes me think that I'm capable of it as well. Now, here's the key. I mentioned earlier the idea of comparing yourself with self-care and self-respect. You have to kind of train yourself to compare yourself in a productive way. You have to train yourself not to get down, not to get sad, not to be defeated and fight that imposter syndrome. You have to try to avoid that and use this as a positive. Now, I'm not saying this is easy, and I'm not saying I don't also have a little bit of jealousy, a little bit of frustration that my stuff doesn't do as well as some of the other people. But I will say that if you try to turn that stuff into a positive, you can more safely compare yourself to others and gain a benefit for yourself along the way. Now, how do you do that? Well, I mentioned this earlier. You understand that other people, that all of us are at different stages of our careers. We have different experiences. We have different paths. Everything about the process for wherever it is that we're trying to go, whatever goals we're trying to achieve, is different per person. So if you understand that, if you feel a level of comfort with that, if you embrace that, if you really believe that, you can start to compare yourself safely to other people. Here's another really good example for me that I think is kind of fun. my wife bought or wanted to buy a Peloton. And so we ended up buying a Peloton. This is a stationary bike and they have the big, huge monitor and you can do classes and you have an instructor and they're telling you to go faster, slower. Now, I never in my mind, never, ever thought that I would enjoy a Peloton ride, a stationary bike. I remember my wife, when we were in New York City, would go to spin classes. And I was like, you mean you just ride a bike the whole time? Like, that's what you do? And I was just like, that sounds like the most boring thing ever. Until I tried the Peloton. So I tried the Peloton and I fell in love with it. And I've ridden the Peloton 2 to 4 times a week since we've gotten it because I absolutely love it. But here's the thing I specifically want to share with you about that. When I first started on Peloton, I had no idea what I was capable of. I did my first ride. I was sweating and I was tired. I did my next ride. I worked a little harder. I did my next ride a little harder. And recently, 4 rides in a row, I set a personal record in terms of output. So it's basically like your number output at the end of a 20 or 30 minute session. And 4 times in a row, I set a PR, a personal record, personal best for me. And what that means is in Peloton specifically, you're able to track what your personal best is along the way as you're doing the cycle. So if I'm at 10 minutes in, I can see what my personal best was at 10 minutes and compare myself. Because of that comparison, because of being competitive, because of wanting to continue to improve, I set PRs or personal records, personal best 4 times in a row. I never would have thought that that 4th time was possible had I not done the 3rd. I never would have thought the 3rd time was possible had I not done the 2nd. Never would have thought the 2nd time was possible had I not had the 1st. So it's these building blocks. This is where you can also compare yourself to yourself. What did you do before? Well, if you've ever done something, that's the minimum of what you're capable of. That means you can do more. I'm not saying you can do more the next day. I'm not saying you don't go through waves and that sort of stuff, ups and downs. But whatever bar you set for yourself, that's you're never not capable of doing that. You may get down. It may take work to get back to that point, but you're never not capable of doing that. And that only comes from comparing yourself, in this case to yourself, but comparing yourself to others. I wholeheartedly believe that you don't know what's possible for yourself until you see other people do it. We're just very limited with ourselves. One, we're typically our biggest critics. We typically sell ourselves short. We typically don't appreciate all the things that we've accomplished. We have a hard time innately of really believing in the things that we've accomplished. I talk about this a lot in the bootcamp as I teach. Is people always talk about their projects. Oh, I just did this, or oh, it's a simple blah, blah, blah. These are people underselling the things that they've accomplished. And we continue to do that with ourselves, which means we're going to set ourselves short when we set goals. So as you think about what are the things you want to accomplish? What are the goals you want to accomplish? Look at how other people have done similar things. Look at what other people are doing in that space. Again, had I not seen the Coder channel and Code Stacker and Floor and Pop and Anya Kubo and all these other YouTubers in the development space have this really well-deserved and awesome growth, I never would have thought it was possible for myself. So moral of the story is, I think you should compare yourself to others. I think you should be aware of what others are doing and what they're capable of and consider yourself capable of doing the same thing. But you have to do it in a way where you put self-care and self-love and self-respect first. You have to understand people are at different stages of their careers, of their journeys. They have different experiences. They have different backgrounds. So if you embrace that, if you're comfortable with that, comparing yourself to others opens up a whole new world that you may not have thought was possible before. That has certainly been the case for me. I'm curious, what do you think about comparing yourself to others? Is that something that you do? Is it something that you avoid? Maybe do you feel a little bit differently about comparing yourself to others after watching this video? Let me know, but this is the first episode of Quick Rants. I appreciate you hanging out. If you have any other rant topics you'd like to see me address, leave those in the comments as well. Thanks as always for checking out the video, and I'll catch you in the next one.